nothing better to do.
Currently on an unnecessary Monday Meander, unnecessary journey, why not? I'm in Tesco and Notting Hill, and there's lots of space in this freezer. I'm thinking of just getting in it. On a mellow road. If you've seen Bedknobs and Broomsticks. Well, I'm there. I'm gonna go down Pembridge Villas and see what there is down there. Then I might get on the tube at Westbourne Park for no reason whatsoever. This is a totally unnecessary journey because the news and the weather was saying don't make any unnecessary journeys. And I think we've had the best part of nearly 2 years of making no unnecessary journeys. So they can go stuff themselves. Oh, this is where the bus goes down. I've been around here before, but on bus. It is boiling up today, it's so hot. I'm surprised none of the buses have caught fire. I mean, there's usually one every summer. Look, it's the almost impossible to find Monster Energy Ultra Blue. I wonder if they've got any in here. No, they did not. But they have got Vera. Hello, Vera. Right. Now, do we go this way or do we go the other way? Oh, look, it's one of them green ups again. I forgot what for. I think it was something to do with the old trams back in the day. And then they were sort of utilised by taxis or something, I think. I don't know. I've forgotten. I'm going to get run over because I'm crossing a road without looking. Oh, this is Kensington Park Road. Kensington Park Road. La. Little pizza van. Now, I don't believe I've walked down this road before. This is different. I've never seen the 452 bus before. Or the 52, I don't think. I don't know if there's any blue plaques on any of these houses. It's got scary faces. I've never understood the meaning of this. Let me know in the comment section down below. Why do they put faces into things like this? I'm going to get decorative architecture and everything, but random faces. And they're all the same. Ooh, this is Horbury Crescent. Well, this just sounds posh, doesn't it? Well, the berry sounded a bit easygoing for it to be a Horbury. Anyway. It seems nice around here.
And if you're wondering, yes, I'm wearing my JML polarized glasses, which I've just taken off and nearly blinded myself because it's really bright. It's actually the time about 5:30, something like that. I just had to get out of the house, it was very hot. Ladbroke Square. Now last Monday I did a Monday Meander, but I didn't upload the video. And I said there's loads of
This is Ladbroke Grove. The reason why there was a bit of a jump there is because my phone got too hot and it decided to stop recording. It looks as if this Monday Meander's gonna be much shorter than I expected. I like the blue and white. Well, it's like a greeny blue. But then I'm looking from polarised glasses and I've got my hands full of everything, so I can't really... I think I've been down here before. Yeah, I have. Because that's where the tube station is and that's where there's a co-op. Because I think I've been down here before. There's loads of these little... alleyways built into houses that actually lead off into more streets. Look how narrow the streets are. Double yellow lines on both sides. A bit unnecessary. I don't think you need double yellows on both sides, but they went for that. Unless you've got an incredibly narrow car, maybe. So what? In fact, I don't know if it caught it or not because it stopped recording. I was saying about I'm surprised none of the buses have burst into flames yet, but they're all really loud because they've got the cooling fans on the battery buses. It's really funny because normally electric cars and buses are so quiet you can't hear them, which is usually a problem, but in the hot weather all you can hear is the cooling fans just whirring away. The flowered corner. Oof, it's hot. I'm gonna stop now before my phone stops me. And here we are at Ladbroke Station. Forgive me for being a bit Jago Hazard. Ladbroke Station was built as part of the London Chatham and Dover Railway. No, it really wasn't. Anyway, I uploaded a short about a coffee shop. Now, you know when you're told as a kid that the best thing you can have on a hot day is a hot drink? Well, this coffee shop thinks differently. This coffee shop will be closed because it's going to be too hot. We'll make some iced coffee then. They've got cold drinks. I've never known a shop to be closed of such because of hot weather. Silly. I don't normally like touching public buttons. Let's cross the road. Right. Due to what weather, the shop's gonna be closed. Ridiculous. Like my phone, I'm too hot. I don't think I'm gonna get a frame rate matched to this, but this is a sign. I wonder if this will make things change. Got a Whammer Smith. Changed my mind, decided to get off at Wood Lane because then I could go into Westfield just for the aircon. Might get an ice cream as well. It was nice to get on the tube actually because it's nice and air conditioning, which means I'm much cooler now. Looks pretty, doesn't it? I don't think anybody's sat out there though because it's too hot. It's because there's no umbrellas or parasols, I suppose you're supposed to call them. Oh, this is silly. All these lovely tables and chairs and no parasols. What are you supposed to do in a bloody heatwave? Bake? Oh, what a wasted opportunity.
I love it when they put this fake grass out there, because it's actually quite, well, it feels as if it's a good quality one. It's quite soft. But, yeah, parasols would have been nice. It's 6:15, so this is strangely quiet out here, but it's probably because everyone's inside, freeloading off the aircon. I hate when places do this. I bet it's got the aircon on, but they've also got the doors open. And they have as well, because I can feel the cold air just rushing out. Stupid. Oh, it's lovely in here. Oh, this is so much better. Oh, if this was future YouTube, if only I could demonstrate to you the temperature difference of being inside to outside. I can see my reflection. Hello. Oh, this is so much nicer. I'm going to go to Boots, get a meal deal, or I might get an ice cream. Obviously, you can't get an ice cream from Boots, but you know what I mean. This is the OnlyFans section of the video. Oh, look at that fan. It goes round and moves all over the place. That is so good. Look at that. Oh, that is so nice. Oh, I love that. John Lewis Spectrum Circulator Stand Mount Fan, £75. I love that. That is so clever. Oh, I was actually contemplating buying it, and the man who works has just told me it's sold out. Of course it is. Oh, no. Oh, I was too late. I'm actually a bit heartbroken. That fan was so good. Well, anyway, Monday Meander continues with me sweating away, but so is everybody else. It's very busy in Westfield because everyone is not even carrying any carrier bags. If you look in the background, there's very few carrier bags. It's people just... some idiots turned the escalator off. The first couple of steps when you're walking up a stopped escalator are so difficult, aren't they? That was actually quite a good price for such an amazing fan. I'm going to have to stop and get over it now. I'm going to have to build a bridge and get over it. They're getting an ambulance in Westfield. That's brilliant. Oh, but that'll be popular. Because there's no toy shop in here, hardly. I mean, there's the entertainer, but this is a much bigger unit. Oh, brilliant! I'm so glad there's a works in Westfield now. I'd never think in a billion years I'd found the works in Westfield. Oh, about flipping time. I'm so glad. Oh, if you don't know what the works is, it's just loads and loads like crafty, chintzy sort of things, but really good prices. I love it in here. Like WH Smith, Smiggle, Scribbler, Paper Chase, Staples, everything like that, all wrapped up into one, but like really good prices. Obviously, this is not a paid for promotion. It also has whatever toy craze is on at the moment, yet the price will be like three times as cheaper. So it's good. And like cheap knockoffs of popular games like Connect 4, and I think there was a Guess Who around the corner. It's a good place to get all your artsy stuff from as well. Oh, I want them really good pencils, actually, whilst I'm in here. There's some really good pencils that I want for work. There's always a good range of books as well, and really good offers. I've bought loads of books from the works. I've decided I'm not getting the pencils, but I am getting the hot glue gun and some glue sticks. See? Now I'm not just freeloading off the aircon. Oh. I love Lego. Perpetually amazing Lego. I've cooled down a lot now, actually. Now I don't want to leave Westfield. It's nice and cold. But
but I'd like to go home at some point. I can't just stay here forever. Although you could, but you couldn't. No, you'd get thrown out. But if you was trapped in here forever, yeah, there's plenty enough for you to live off, isn't there? Now I am going to go to Heavy Tulip now, which they call themselves Waitrose, but I like to call it Heavy Tulip. Better get a basket, and I. Man, Stu, I'm in Heavy Tulip. I suppose I should call it a basket.
Oh, God. It was like a wall of heat when I left Heavy Tulip.
Although I have got myself a lovely trifle.
Looking forward to my trifle when I get in.
I think it just showed.
Shepherd's Bush Green is Shepherd's Bush Dead at the minute, or Shepherd's Bush Brown. And just getting near the run over by a Just Eat. Oh, is that Deliveroo? Why is he wearing both uniforms?
Don't know.
Oh, someone called the police. It wouldn't be a Monday Meander without the police feature in it somewhere, would it? I'm surprised that Costa Coffee has actually shut down permanently. And it's got a little bit of a garden at the back. It's in a great location. Yes. That's the same police. Look how dry and dead the grass has got. It's a shame. Butterflies! Oh. Are they all right? There's two of them. Butterfly. Should they be on the concrete like this?
I'm saving a butterfly's life. I think I'm saving its life. It shouldn't be on the concrete, should it? It was just there. Should I put it on the tree? Oh, I can't take you home with me. There we are, put it on the tree.
I've never been one for sunbathing. It just looks like a Shepherd's Bush triage now. Just like all lounging around. No, I'm not a summer person at all.
Another reason why I hate sunbathers is because the lazy bar stewards can't walk, what, all of 30 metres to put the rubbish in a bin? And I've done a good deed for the day. I could have put them things in the bin, but I've just saved two butterflies' lives.
Okay, I've done my bit for the environment. And no good deed goes unpunished. So, what's punishment am I going to have now? I don't know. Oh, what's playing at the Shepherd's Bush Empire? Let's have a look. Modest Mouse. I have no idea what that is. Haven't got the foggiest. I have no idea.
Well, that was Monday Meander. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, let me know in the comment section down below anything you want to know.
Another closed down Costa. Costa obviously was bought by Coca-Cola not much before lockdown. And the idea behind it, they said, was to break into selling chilled coffee in shops and whatnot. I mean, there was a lot of money in the Costa brand. But that is two closed down Costa shops quite close to each other.